borrow this earring. Oh. Is that okay? I need to borrow that one. I need to borrow this one too. Oh my gosh. I can borrow that one.
What's in her ears?
Artemis, will you put your hand out for me like that? Okay, so everyone knows this is ball A, all right? And this is ball B. Okay, you hold ball E. I mean ball A. This is ball B. I'll hold ball B just like this, and you do the same thing. Ready, watch. On the count of three, you're gonna feel this. One, two, three. Did you feel that?
Yeah.
Look. Check. They switched places.
Oh.
They switched places. I promise. If you don't believe me, keep your hand open all the way. See, you have ball B now, and I have ball A. But if I take ball A and hold it real tight, you hold ball B as tight as you can. Ready? Watch mine. It'll disappear completely. Just like that. Totally gone.
Wow.
And you can check. Open your hands.
What?
Right? So it's fast. It's fast. And do you want to try too? You can try too. Put your hand up and watch. Sometimes, oh, they're gone.
They're back in your
hand. Nope, they're back in your ears. No, they're in your ears. But they take 24 hours for them to come out. So just check around tomorrow. All right, look, this is a normal, ordinary deck of cards. All normal, they're all different. And Artemis, I would like you to please take out one card as I go through. Anyone, it doesn't matter. All right, good. And now, I want you to write your name on the face of that card. On this side, like on this side. Yep, you can see they're all different. And we're gonna try an experiment. All right, good. So once she writes her name on the card, it becomes the only card like that in the world, right? Now I'm gonna take this, and I need you to put your hand out like that. And would you put your hand above hers? Put your hand like an inch above hers, perfect. Okay, so her card, her sign card, right? I want you to hold that flat, just like that. That's real good. And will you put your hand on top too? That's good, good. Okay, now we'll use the next card. We're gonna use the two, okay? We're gonna use the two of hearts over her sign card and watch. As slow as I can do it, look, you're gonna feel this, watch. Like that, did you feel it? Look.
What?
And you can check, look.
What?
Right, so it's fast, and that's on there, good. The ink is on there, really good, right? Now look, who here knows who Harry Houdini was? Does anyone know who is Harry Houdini? He was a magician. He was a very, very famous magician. And when he was a famous magician, he would invite other magicians over to his house to try to fool him. And no one could fool Harry Houdini. He knew how every single trick worked. But there was one guy, his name was Di Vernon, and he could trick Houdini. This is actually the trick he did, and it became known as the trick that fooled Harry Houdini. He would take a sign card, and you put it about halfway into the deck, and watch, just like this, like that, and you can check the top card. You get it? And it'll keep going back up, because the thing with this, who knows some of the rules of magic? What's one rule of magic? You never do the same trick twice, right? But this trick was different because you could do it more than once. I could take the sign card, right? And we'll put it in right down there. And you can hold the top. And I'm gonna let you guys in on a secret. When I put it in, I actually do this, which is called holding a break. So that's how I know where the card is. From here, it looks normal, but right there, that's where the card is. And then you do a quick move, like a one-handed cut, where you can get it back onto the top. It always goes to the top, no matter what. It always goes to the top. Oh no, wait, that's the top though. You have the top over there. Right? So it's quick. Now this time I'm gonna give you guys a chance. I want you to try to catch me. Really stare at the hand, see if you can catch it. Okay, your sign card. All right? Now push it in all the way. Oh wait, it's in my mouth. That will happen sometimes.
Wow, how about that?
You can do it like this too. Ready, watch. Face up, if you shake it like that, see how it'll change into the two? Now look, do you know where it went that time? That time it went in to my pocket. Yes, your sign card in the pocket. Do you believe me? If you don't believe me, I'll show you. It actually is your sign card. Now, a lot of people think it goes up, across, and then down into the pocket, but that's not what I did. What I did is I palmed it, which is something magicians have been doing for a long time. It's when you hold the card in your hand so you can't see it, like that, and then you fold it, and then you make it disappear. Like that, see? Do you know where it went?
Yeah.
It went back in to the pocket, I hope. Yes. Your sign card. And I always give these out as a souvenir. Sorry. I didn't mean to do that. That happens from time to time. But maybe, hopefully, actually, if you hold the pieces, squeeze them tight. Squeeze them really tight and try to see them going back together. Try to envision it in your head. See if you can see the pieces, and you squeeze your hand too. And really try to see them going back together. Can you feel them sticking together in your hands? Now, Shaq, open your hand.
Wow. What? Wait.
How'd you do that?
I don't know.
Alright, now let's try this. Who knows what three card money is? You do? What is it? Yeah. Yes, exactly. So it's when you have three cards and you mix them all around so that, and you have to like find the queen. It's a game. Have you guys ever seen that when they mix them around? Now look, will you put your hand out, Artemis, just like this? This is a game we're all gonna play. We're gonna see who can get it, all right? Because I'm gonna teach you how I do this and then I'm gonna try to shoot. Or I'm gonna teach you and then I'm gonna show you and you still might not notice. That's how quick it is. So if I give you the queen of diamonds, okay? Now hold on to the queen. Now without turning that over, what card do you think it is without looking? You can check and make sure. Oh, okay, the queen, good. So now I'm gonna teach you the move, so put it back. So you can lift up your head, because now we're all gonna play. Lift up. All right, watch, this is the secret move, okay? I take the king, and then this is the secret move, I slide you the king. So now I have the queen. Now hold the king really tight, hold it real tight. So if I did it twice, I'd still have the queen, right? But if I did it three times without looking, do you think I got it or no? Because I could do it two more. Is the king on top or on bottom?
Bottom.
Wait, you think it's on bottom? Wait, because actually, can I see your hat? Because sometimes you can actually get them right there.
I saw you had it in your hand.
I
so if you can check, look at those. Turn those over.
Turn them.
Check.
What? It's not in my hat.
Right?
What? I see.
So it's fast. You never want to play that game.
Why is there a Joker here? Why is there a Joker here?
Alright, now let's see. I want you to check these, make sure those are normal coins. They're normal quarters, right? Alright, now watch. Can I see? Now if we shake the coins, they heat up. Do you guys know why they heat up? Why do you think? Because it's metal from the body heat and from the friction from when we shake them and throw them back and forth, right? Now watch the first coin. The first one you're going to see go over. Watch. Like that. See how you can get one to go over? Now that one's kind of easy because you don't know what's coming. But these two to join with this one is a little harder. But watch right here. And you can see we still have one coin. But watch the second time. You're going to hear it. Look. Like that, and you can get two coins across, right? Now this last one is the hardest to join with these two, because you know it's coming, but watch, ready?
Wow.
Across, just like that. And there are normal coins, I promise. I'm going to show you guys this one too, just so I don't have the advantage. Because magicians do have quick hands, right? Now the name of this game is to follow the cap. And this is kind of like the other thing. They do this in New York too. You can take the cap right here. And if you throw it like that, it'll go up over into the other hand, right? It's the first rule of magic. It's always in the other hand. Watch, the second time it's a little faster. I want you to see, look, right here. It's a little faster. If you take it like that, you can make it look like it goes and then tap and wave. And it'll come back, right? And that's normal too. But watch, the third time is when you have them bet their money right here, and you can actually make the pen go. But put your hand out and hold on to the cap. Oh no, it's in my face. That will happen sometimes. And then there's always the favorite. I had to do it. And we're going to do another one, but this time I don't want you to let me see the card, okay? So you can take one out, anyone, but don't let me see it. Anyone you want. Whichever one you want. Okay, but don't let me see it, and I want you to write your name on it so we don't forget.
It says someone's name already.
That's okay. You can write your name on it too. But don't let me see. I'll turn around.
Okay, watch out for your skirt. Watch out for your skirt.
I can see him walking.
Look at him walking.
Their body flexible.
And let me know when your name's on it. Are you done? I can't see it. You turn it around.
Captain Martin.
Oh yeah, I'll take this. That's okay. All right. I want you to say stop anywhere. Okay, right there. You can put it in. Put your card in. And you definitely remember what it was, right? Okay, so we're gonna shuffle it, but we're gonna shuffle it face up and face down, okay? And this is actually one of the first tricks that I ever learned at a magic shop. And I want you guys to see this card's going every single way, right? Yeah, a big mess. Card's going back to face, face to back. See, back to face, face to back, and probably somewhere even back to back, right? And that wasn't your card, was it? Okay, good. So if we were to put the cards, not in the right order, but just so that they were all facing the same way, about how long do you think it would take? What would be, like, how long do you think it would take? A few seconds. All right, the pressure is on. Ready, watch. I'm gonna try to get them to all face the same way, just like that. You can actually get the whole deck.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, wait.
Ooh, is that your card?
Except one card. And you can check, look.
That was my card.
Oh my gosh.
I should have put it at the end. I know that trick.
At the very end?
Yeah. All right.
Let's see, now we're going to try one, but we need two people for this one. I'm going to have... All right, we'll have... I'll use you two, but you'll take one out first. You can take out anyone you want, any card you want. All right, good. Don't let me see it. Remember what it is. And I want you to take out one card, too. Anyone. All right. Now remember what they are. Show everybody. Don't let me see.
Let me see, Sarah.
Yeah, I
saw the thank yous.
Okay, did everyone see them? All right. Now, you were going to say stop anywhere? Okay, right there, you can put your card in. And you definitely remember what it was, right?
Yep.
And you can put yours on top. Okay, good. And we're going to shuffle yours in. And you guys, did everyone see both cards? You did? Okay. So, I'm going to see if I can find one. I'm going to do a special cut, fancy cut, just like this. And I think I found it. I think I found one of the cards. Is that? Yeah. That one was yours? Okay, so we're going to take yours. We're going to put it right there. And, let me see for a second. Because we're going to use your card to find the other one. I want you to say stop anywhere. Right there? So what one was it over? This one? This one right here, right? Watch. Alright, now we're gonna see. Now we're gonna try one with you, Artemis. We're gonna see if you can do the magic this time. I want you to take one out. Just grab one as I go through. Anyone, it doesn't matter. Okay, good. Don't let me see. And you could have taken any card, right? Now take. Remember what it is. Show everybody what it is.
Let me see, Artemis. Artemis.
And you can take the whole deck. Remember what your card is, and put it into the deck. And then once it's in, you can shuffle it up too. Okay, so is it in there? All right, mix it up good. So this is pretty fair so far. You pick any card, you put it anywhere in the deck, and you're shuffling it up. No, that's okay. And when it's good and mixed, you think it's good and mixed now? Okay, good. So, somewhere in here is your card. And I'm gonna see if you can find the card, because I've shown that I can find it already, right? So we're gonna make piles, all right? Just random piles like that. And I want you to come and touch the top of any two of the decks. Any two. And what other one? And this one? Okay. Now touch the top of any other two. All right? And any other two, it can be any ones you want. All right? Now, any other two. Okay. Good. So, one, now we only have two, right? And one's a little closer to you. It's a little smaller, I've handled it less. Maybe most people might think I want you to take that one. This one's bigger, it's further away, but it could go either way. I want you to take a second, really think about it, and I want you to touch the top of one of the decks. Okay, are you sure? You don't want to change your mind? All right, good. So, you put your card anywhere in the deck. You shuffled it up and you chose the order of the cards, right? And we got down to one card on top. I want you to check. You remember what it was? I want you to check and turn it over. How do you do that? Everyone give Artemis a round of applause. That was all her.
Wow.
Very good, very good. All right, now. A lot of magic. A lot of magic tricks are like sleight of hand, right? It's just having quick hands and stuff like that. But some magic tricks have to do with the mind, like mind reading and levitation and other stuff like that, right? So I have two spoons. They are normal, ordinary spoons, right? And I want you to pick spoon A or spoon B, whichever one you want. You've got spoon A or spoon B. You want spoon A? Okay, take spoon A and hold it flat in your hand like this. Watch, I'm gonna do mine first, but watch, if you rub the spoon like this, look, when you focus on it, it'll heat up, and you can actually get it to start to bend, just like that, if you really focus. You just have to focus your mind and remember that there is no spoon.
It looks smaller.
Yeah, you can try. Try and bend it back. And did you get yours? It's hard, right? It's kind of hard. But they are
what
real spoons. What's that? Yeah, you do it on that side. But do you guys remember, like, what? It's like, do you know like the pencil trick that you would do, like where you would shake a pencil and you could kind of make it look like this, like it's bending if you shake it right? But the pencil one, oh no, the pencil one you do this way, right? You do it like this, but watch, you can do it like this too. If you focus the heat in your hands on the spoon, watch, sometimes you can do it. You can make it look like it starts to bend, right? Like that, but it's just an optical illusion. It's like the pencil thing, but you can do it like this too, watch. See how it starts to look like it melts? It's just an illusion, it's not really melting. Unless you do it like this, then you can actually get it.
What? It's actually melting, but there's just a little bit of force.
Can I try?
Put your hand out.
It's hot? Like this. Does it, is hot or not?
It is a little hot, be careful.
Is it hot, Artie?
It's not hot.
Did you get yours? You can do it like this too, look, if you take both the pieces. Yeah, man. Watch.
Come on, Anthony, try harder.
Everybody touch.
It's actually working.
Oh my gosh, something's gonna explode there. Oh.
I'm using all the string.
You get it?
And it's actually bending.
Is it a bend a little? Break it.
Look, watch, we'll try this too with you, Artemis, with another spoon. Put your hand out, squeeze it tight. Squeeze it really tight, watch, and you're gonna feel this, okay? You're gonna feel it happen. Look. Can you feel
it, Artemis?
Can you feel it twisting?
Yeah, it's bending.
Oh.
You can check, open your hand.
Wait!
Oh.
It's twisted.
Wow.
All right, let's try this too.
Let me see.
What about you? Put them in your arm.
Oh, really?
What's
that, huh? It is hot spoon. Yeah. Oh, he did it.
So guys, how's the magic show so far? Did you catch a few of the tricks? No.
Look, he fixed it.
Nice.
Oh wow, he fixed it.
Wow.
Oh my. He had magic too.
Nice
he can fix
job,
it.
Anthony.
Okay,
we already can fix it? No.
It's right here. This is my prediction, all right?
Huh?
We're going to leave that right there.
Okay. You are amazing.
And this is a ring. You can look at that. Look at that ring. All right.
I'm bending it. Look. It's working.
Good work. And I am going to teach you guys some tricks at the end, too, so you'll all be able to learn magic. All right. In this book right here.
Who's that, the Bible?
This is not a Bible. It is
a
magician.
Bible.
But this book.
Bible.
So you know how everything we've been doing is magic tricks, and then some of the stuff with the spoons is kind of like with the mind, right? This book is called 13 Steps to Mentalism, and it teaches you how to be psychic. This book came out in the late 1800s, and Harry Houdini actually tried to get this book banned because he didn't like psychics. He didn't believe in them. He thought they were just doing tricks, just like all the magicians. And I want you to look through the book and check and just make sure that all the words in the book are different. They're all different. I want you to pick any page that doesn't have pictures on it. Just one with a lot of words. You want this one, this side? Okay. Now I'm gonna put my ring on the book and I want you to say stop as I go down anywhere. Okay, right there. I'm gonna move it up a little because we were on, like not on the paragraph. I want you to look into the ring, into the center of the ring. And I want you to pick a big word. Don't pick a word like the. Pick a word that has more than one syllable and one that's in the middle. So you want followed? Okay. And you could have picked any word. Even within the ring, there were more than one word in the ring, right? And all, they were all different, right? And now, we've had this out here the whole time. So you picked any page, you said stop anywhere going down the book, and you picked the word followed. And you could have picked any word in the ring, right? In this prediction, I wrote last night, because I had a vision, I thought I could see this, I could see it happening. Check that, open it up.
What? That says followed.
Wow!
Amazing.
What if I choose something else? Sounds like a
pen. You would have been in trouble. Like,
and then he would fail his magic.
He failed magic.
That's amazing, Artemis. He wrote it last night. That's crazy. He knew what he knew which word you're gonna choose, Artemis.
He
knew yesterday when he wrote this down which word you're gonna choose.
That's amazing. What if I choose something else?
Well, you didn't. That's the thing.
All right, now we're all gonna learn some magic tricks. Do you guys want to learn some tricks?
Yes.
All right. These are ordinary laughs.